Jacksonville Jaguars Muslim owner just made disgusting announcement ahead of tomorrow's game. No one should be surprised that a Muslim wouldn't get why fans are upset about the NFL players and their inconsiderate protest. I really do not understand why it's so hard to grasp this concept, of being considerate of the fans who go to a game to see a game, not a protest. For Muslims, they don't believe that the Constitution applies to them, only Sharia law is what they think they answer to. The reason why this Muslim owner brings President Trump into the picture is obvious. President Trump has no problem stating who the United States is at war with, which is radical Islam. He is not afraid to state the truth of the enemy of humanity and does not answer to Sharia law. Via downtrend. Even millionaire Muslims haven't quite figured out that assimilation thing. Shahid Khan is the owner of the Jackson Jaguars and the only Muslim owner in the NFL. You'd think just being rich would allow him to bond with his fellow millionaire, billionaire owners, but that's not how Islam works. Instead of finding camaraderie with them, Khan came and said they are all a bunch of racists. I'm guessing he sits a table by himself at the league's annual owners meeting. Khan did an interview with Crane's Chicago Business and of course they had to talk about race, Trump, and the national anthem. You've got a bunch of 85-year-old guys who don't think they're racist, but they are racist, said Khan of his fellow owners. Why? How? Khan doesn't say. That's the cool thing about calling someone a racist. You just do it and never have to explain or back the statement up with proof. Making this accusation of racism even worse, sometime after the interview Khan clarified that he had heard the other owners were racist and it was not something that he actually knew. If you don't know someone is racist, don't make a statement that they are racist. It's really that simple. Khan of course supports black players kneeling for the national anthem, though he does seem a bit confused. I had heard from a lot of the players what their feelings were, how offended they were, by Trump's comments, and what they were going to do, and my concern was that they don't do anything to hurt themselves. We wanted to do something as a team, because a team divided against itself cannot stand, Khan said. The problem was and is that the players weren't standing at all. The issue is not that they cannot stand, it's that they won't. Also, if Khan is worried that his players were offended that the President of the United States wants them to show a little respect for the flag, he should see the reaction from the rest of the country, except liberals, who are disgusted by player protests. Khan, who actually gave $1 million to Trump's inauguration, has now soured on the president. He called him the Great Divider and then accused Trump of exploiting fear and anger for political gain. How do I get elected? I get elected by dividing this person or this group against this group. What are the worst fears, phobias somebody has? How do I tap that button and get them with my people? There's a lot of predictive behavior here, Khan said of Trump's strategy. When asked whether that strategy is dangerous for the nation's future, he added, "We saw the corner stores get replaced by department stores get replaced by Walmart and e-commerce. What, Trump, has done is shown leadership as the great divider, not uniter. We are used to being warm and fuzzy and cuddled. Well, it's a different time." What the hell does Trump have to do with Walmart eating all local competition? And for that matter, what does this have to do with dividing our nation? Is he trying to say that our country's biggest problem is pro-Walmart and anti-Walmart forces being at each other's throats? Maybe. Khan, who owns an auto parts company, also advocated for a $20 minimum wage because of something about women and small Hispanic people. Think I'm exaggerating? Boom. We didn't have an excuse why a woman couldn't work on the line or why a small, Hispanic person couldn't work on the line. And it was really good for us because we were producing the highest quality parts, paying people well because tech and evolution have taken us there, said Khan. The reason why this Muslim owner brings President Trump into the picture is obvious. President Trump has no problem stating who the United States is at war with, which is radical Islam. He is not afraid to state the truth of the enemy of humanity and does not answer to Sharia law. The United States doesn't just represent white Americans. The U.S. represents all Americans, white, black, etc. To say that the owners who are enforcing the players to stand are racist is ignorant. The flag, anthem, represents the American way of life, and the Constitution is the law that binds it all together. No one is saying no to free speech, but what the fans are asking is simple. Protest somewhere else. This has nothing to do with race regarding the fans' anger and frustration. Americans have died for the flag and what it means. Yes, you have the freedom to do what you want or say what you want, but doesn't mean you should. Technically, in a private organization, you are in fact limited on what you can do. The owners have the right, by law, to penalize the players who chose to ignore that law, again nothing to do with racism. It's all about consideration for the fans who use their hard-earned money to see a game, not a protest.